Oh, you trackies and TV addicts. Don't mean to this, don't mean to bring static. Oh, you cling onto your grandma's house. Grab your back street friend to get loud. Blowing doors off inches. And no, I didn't retire.
This is gonna be a great year for more than we can. And I made all kinds of stuff. But I want to show you, I got my tequila lime chicken here in the marinade and stuff. Okay, I've done this before, so it's on the website. Okay, so we're having this one day. And then over here, I just caught a loin of pork. And that's what this show is about, the quickie's about. It's going to be the Fireball Pan Blackened Pork Loin. Okay, so it's all about the pork, no chicken. Okay, so I just want to show you what I'm doing with this real quick. I took a nice thick double cut and I tied it to band it together to make it round and to stay thick and juicy. Okay, I did two of them and I'm going to show you one. Okay, I got my butcher's twine here. Right, let me get over here so you can get a better view of this. I got my butcher's twine and then I got my chop. And I'm going to take my string and I'm going to go around the center and I'm going to tie it into a knot. See how that gets nice? Nice and fat. See that? And then I'm going to tie it into another knot to hold it. Okay. Oh, and then I'm gonna take my knife and I'm gonna cut the string. I'm gonna do one more for you. See? That's gonna be a beautiful chop. Okay, now here, got this one here. Got the end of my string. Okay. I'm gonna come around in the center, like so. I'm gonna come around and then I'm just gonna tie it slowly and squeeze it up till it turns into a nice round, like filet mignon type piece. And then I'm gonna tie it into the knot, if I can get it. Look at this, right? I'm on camera, so it doesn't, let me tie it. Okay, it's really not that hard. There we go. Okay, and then I'm gonna cut my string. Okay, let me just do one more for you. Okay. Got the end of my string. I'm gonna come around. Come around and tie it into a knot. Look at that. Oh, those are gonna be beautiful. Okay. Okay. Now that's part one. Look how beautiful that is. Okay, that's part one. I'll be back to show you how I marinate them up. Okay, welcome back. We're gonna do the marinade now for this Fireball blackened pork loin. Okay, so I have all my pork loins tied, right? Here we go, I got a bowl. I have a cup of pineapple juice. I have 2 tablespoons of garlic. Gonna mix that in. Right? And then we're gonna put about 4 ounces. 4 ounces of extra virgin olive oil in that. Okay? Then we're gonna take some paprika and we're gonna probably put in about 1/2 tablespoon's worth of paprika, okay? And then we're gonna take onion powder and we're gonna put in almost 1 tablespoon's worth of onion powder in that, okay? Let me get a little whip. I'm gonna whip that up, okay? And what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna dip them and I'm gonna put them in here. Like so. I got 7 beautiful, beautiful chops here. Okay. Okay, and these are going to be finished in the oven. Once we blacken them on top of the stove, we're going to finish them in the oven. Okay, so now I got this mix going on these, right? Let me get some of that garlic on that one. Okay, and now I'm going to put some on the top. The rest of it on here. Now it's 10 o'clock in the morning. Okay, we're not going to eat till about 6:30, 7 o'clock tonight. So these are going to stay in this marinade. And I'm not done. I'm going to show you what I'm going to do next. We're going to get all of this on here. Okay. Let me clean my hands. Okay. And now, I got brown sugar. Let me get a spoon. And I'm going to put a tablespoon or more of brown sugar on each one of these. Okay, and I'm going to mash it down, let it melt on top of these, okay, the more the merrier, okay, okay, I'm going to put a plastic bag around these. I'm going to put them in the refrigerator, and they're going to be there until we're ready to cook them. And when we're ready to cook them, I'll take them out and show you how we do it. And also with this meal, I'm making a pineapple mango chutney to go with this. And we're going to have a stuffing cake, like a crab cake style, but stuffing. Okay, so we're going to serve that, but that's not the quickie. The quickie is doing this blackened pork loin. Okay, with the fireball glaze. Okay, so I'll be back when we're gonna do that, when we're gonna start to make that. Hey, welcome back, okay? And I'm gonna show you how to make this mango and pineapple chutney, okay? But in the quickie version, all right? So right here, I have 1/3 cup of yellow pepper, 1/3 cup of red pepper, a large tablespoon or one medium-sized jalapeno, no seeds, diced up into a small little fine dice. I have a large tablespoon of cilantro here. I have 1.5 tablespoons of ginger, and I have a large shallot, all diced up into a small dice and chopped, okay? Over here, I have a small pineapple that I put in the food processor and ground up, okay? And it's starting to leach out. It's pineapple juice, which is cool. We want that, okay? I got 2 mangoes, and that's what I'm gonna show you. We're gonna need 1 cup of brown sugar again, okay? So I just wanna show you something. I saw this on the web, and I wanted to show you guys how to peel a mango. You gotta get one that's ripe, right? Let's get one that's ripe, and you know there's a long seed in it that looks like this. Okay, it's kind of flat. Alright, so what we're going to do is we're going to take our mango and we're going to try to go down the center, and then we're going to cut along the pit. Like so. Okay, this one's really ripe. So, we want that. We're going to do the same thing with this one. Okay? And let me just put this over here. And then what we're going to do is we're going to take our 1/2 mango and we're going to take a plastic glass. You don't want to use a real glass just in case it breaks. But you just take your mango, you put it in the back, look, and you slide it down. See that? You take your mango, put it in the back, and just slide it along the glass, and it peels it perfectly. Okay, let me get that mango in here. Okay, now we're going to take the mango, I'm going to put it on the glass, and we're just gonna push it down. And look, you got that mango, okay? So now I'm gonna chop this up, and when I chop it up, then we're gonna be back and we're gonna put it together. Okay, I got that all chopped up here, all right? And we're ready to go. All right, so I got my pineapple and my mango. That's gonna go in last, okay? This is going in first, okay? I have my pan. I just put my pan on the fire. I got 2 tablespoons of olive oil in it, okay? We're getting that hot. 2 tablespoons of extra virgin olive oil. You could use regular olive oil. You could use vegetable oil if you wanted to, okay? So let's get this going. I just want to make this stuff translucent in here, okay? So I'm going to put this on. I'm going to go with the shallot. The ginger. The cilantro. Wow. I smell that coming up already. Okay. Give that a little turn around. And now the peppers and the jalapeno. All of that in there, right? Now we don't want to brown this. We just want to make it translucent. Okay? Okay. Get a little bit closer to this. There we go. Look at that. We just want to make that a little translucent to get that started. Now this chutney, you could serve it warm or cold. We're going to have it cold tonight. I'm making this now. It's 11:30 and I want to be done with everything that I got to do by 12:30, and we're going to eat. I'm going to start cooking at 6:30. So I'm going to have like 6 hours to hang out when my company gets here and stuff, and not have to worry about any of this stuff. I'm making shrimp cocktail. I'm making a spinach artichoke, hot spinach artichoke dip. Okay, that's good. This weekend we're going to have a capri salad with fresh mozzarella, basil, and fresh nice tomatoes from the farm stand. Okay, that's the pineapple, and now the mango. Okay, so that's 2 mangoes, a small pineapple. If you got a large pineapple, use half of it or 3/4 of it, as much as little as you want. Okay? Okay, now we're gonna mix this up really nice. We're going to let a little bit of that liquid reduce down. I got to get those pork chops in the fridge. But look how beautiful they look. Just getting nice and happy. Okay. Now that I got this going here, one thing next, the only thing that we have to add to this is going to be a cup of brown sugar. Okay? It don't have to be exactly a cup. I'm going to eyeball it like I always do. Okay, but we want to mix this up really good. And we want to get this boiling so it breaks down just a little bit and gets like a chutney kind of fashion. Look how nice that looks. I can't wait to taste it. Now, if you wanted to, you could add a little honey to this. There's a lot of different ways you can make it, but I'm just going to put the brown sugar in. Okay, more of a traditional style. Okay. Now remember, I'm going to serve this with a stuffing cake, and I'll show you those. It's just from leftover stuffing I had in the freezer, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to fry them to make a cake out of it, so it has a better presentation than just taking a scoop of stuffing. Okay. So I'm gonna put in like a cup of this. Let me get a measuring spoon. Where do I have my measuring spoons at? Wouldn't you know it? Okay. Let me just, I'm gonna eyeball it. There you go. That's about a cup. Okay. That's gonna go in. And I'm gonna reduce the heat by half. And I'm gonna let this cook down for about 5 minutes and I'll show you.
Okay, that's been boiling for 5 minutes. All right?
And right here, I have a tablespoon of cornstarch and about 2 tablespoons of water. Okay? And I'm gonna just slowly drizzle just a little. I'm not gonna use it all. I'm gonna just drizzle a little bit in. And that's gonna tighten it up. So it's not gonna be runny. See that? Normally I use arrowroot or another thickening agent, but I didn't have it. So cornstarch will work out fine. You just wanna cook it for a minute to boil out any taste of the cornstarch that's in it, and you won't taste it at all. Look at that chutney. Wow. That looks awesome. Look at that. Okay. I'll turn the flame off. I'm gonna let it sit on here for a minute and keep stirring it. You know, with electric. Beautiful. I'm gonna transfer it into another bowl. And I'm gonna put it on a rack to cool in the refrigerator. Okay, we're also having a shrimp cocktail with that, but let me show you this first, okay? That's the pineapple mango chutney. That's awesome, right? I have some left over. Then I'm gonna put a little on the plate, and I'm gonna give everybody a cap of it with their meal. Okay, now here, I got 21/25s, all peeled and ready to go. I have a quart bouillon over here. Okay, a quart bouillon is water, a little bit of white wine, celery, peppercorns, bay leaf, some carrot, and some squeezed lemon. Okay, I'm gonna put these in here, and I'm gonna cook them bad boys up. Okay? Now they're gonna poach in there. I actually have less water than I'm supposed to have, but being that I'm gonna be moving them around and cooking them, I'm gonna make sure that I have these cooked. Okay, rule of thumb is 3 times as much water as you have shrimp. So we're gonna let these cook. They're gonna be nice sized shrimp. These are gonna be with the shrimp cocktail. Okay, these shrimp are about done. And when you wanna test the shrimp, you take it out and you squeeze it and you feel the firmness of it. When they're semi-firm and not real mushy, they're done. So these are done. So let me show you what's gonna happen here. Okay, I'm gonna take my pan off the fire. I'm coming over, okay, and I'm going to drain out the water, the poaching liquid, as much of it as I can, right? Then I have a bowl with some ice in it and cold water. We're going to chill them down. Okay, now I'm gonna put them in the container when they're done, when they're chilled, and then I'm gonna set up the shrimp cocktail before dinner, and I'll show you all of that. So next time you see me, we'll be getting everything ready for dinner. Okay, and here's the spinach dip, right, that I make. It's also on the webpage, okay, so if you wanna make an artichoke,
parts, spinach, okay, topped with mozzarella cheese or provolone, whatever you prefer. Okay, I make it, it's on the website, just type in spinach dip and it should come up at Scott the Grill Man Grippo Chef on YouTube. Now that's done. Okay, I'm back, okay? And shit's going a little haywire because things are running late. We've been doing things, and the biggest problem is two friends have come over that have really put a damper on what's going on. And it's Tito and Fireball. They came over to hang out and party with us. And when that happens, I'm in trouble, okay? So let's get going with this. All right, I gotta get a little container here, okay? And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna drain off the remainder of that liquid that I have the pork marinating in, okay? So I got that kind of like drained off. Whoops, okay. I kind of got that drained off. I got these here, they still got that crust, that hard brown sugar on it, okay? Okay, I got plates with my chutney on it, and I also have chutney that I'm gonna put on the table for extra, okay? Over here, I have a pan on the fire with about 2 tablespoons of olive oil in it, okay? And we're gonna get that bad boy really, really super hot, okay? And I got this half a stick of butter and a tablespoon of olive oil melting down here for the crab cake, for the stuffing cake, okay? And then here, I have the stuffing cakes that we made earlier and some flour. I'm gonna flour them, I'm gonna brown them, I'm gonna stick this pan in the oven, and they're gonna get nice and toasty, and they're gonna be moist inside and crispy on the outside. Okay, so we're getting this going here, okay? And this is going here, getting this really nice and hot. That's a little more oil than I need, so I'm gonna just put it in there, okay? So let's get back over here for a second. So now I have these here, and while I'm waiting for all of that stuff to get hot, I'm gonna take my little mixer, okay? I'm gonna fill it with ice. I got everybody hanging out outside already. Okay, so I got that here. Can you see me here? I'm gonna put a little bit of pomegranate juice in that. Okay, I'm gonna take my Tito's. I'm gonna put that in there. Oh, I smell that oil getting hot, right? I'm gonna forego the orange. And I'm gonna mix that up. Okay, can you see that? Oh, that oil's getting hot, I can smell it. Okay, so let me get this going. Priorities, priorities. Oh, beautiful, look at that. Okay, now let's come over here. Okay, let me turn that down and pull that off the fire a little bit because that's really hot. Okay, so now I'm gonna take my cakes and I'm gonna put them in the flour one at a time, and I'm gonna put them in the hot oil and butter. Okay? Okay, right in the flour. See that? And then in the... Okay? Okay? Never scripted, never rehearsed. Dad can cook. Okay? Try it. Okay, we'll get them out of the way. Wipe my hands off. Where's my small spatula? Gotta find my small, there we go, my little guy. This is my little guy, I like using him. Okay, and I'm putting this back on the fire here, this hot one. Okay, while this is, I got my oven preheating. Okay, it's up, I want it at 450, so it's almost there. I'm browning these right here, right? This oil is getting real hot right here. I'm gonna push these down. Nice crisp stuffing. See that? Okay, this oil's gotta get really hot, right here. If that's cooking, that's gonna go in the oven in a second. First, happy Memorial Day. Nothing better than that pomegranate martini. Okay, so now I have these here. I'm gonna put them in the oven. Metal tray, metal pan, metal handle, in the oven. Turning this flame off. I don't need that flame on anymore. Okay, so we're gonna come over here. Oh, look at that pan smoking. I don't wanna turn my fan on because you won't hear me talking. But now we're gonna start this here. Okay? So we're gonna take it, sugar side. One. Two, three, yum, four, ow, ow, that burns, five, and six, okay, that big bad boy's mine right there, that one's mine, okay, so now we're going to let that just cook. All right, that is just gonna cook. I'm not gonna touch them, I'm gonna let them cook. Okay, now, it's 7:07. Those are gonna cook for like 3 minutes on here. At 7:10, I'm gonna turn them over and put them in the oven. So, I'm not gonna touch them. I'm just gonna let them cook, okay? So I'll be back in three and a half minutes. This has been cooking for 3.5 minutes now. And let's check this out. Look at that. Okay? I'm gonna turn these bad boys over. Oh yeah, that's what I want. That's what I want. I want that color. Oh yeah, look at that. Okay, you see that? That's nice. Now,
oh my God.
I'm gonna take a little bit of that juice and I'm gonna put it in here. Just pour it around, just a little bit of that marinade that I had it in, right? Because I don't want them to dry out. And I'm gonna stick these in the oven for like 4 minutes, okay? Let me check these crab cakes. I mean these, I keep calling them crab cakes. These stuffing cakes, oh, they're nice and soft. You see this? They're nice and soft and they're browning nicely. I'm gonna leave them on the top shelf. Okay, and I'm gonna take these and I'm gonna stick them in the oven on the medium shelf for four minutes. Okay, I don't want them in there longer than 4 minutes. Then when I pull it out, I'm gonna hit it with the glaze, with the fireball. And I'm gonna make the glaze. I'll be right back in 4 minutes.
Okay, it's almost done.
All right? All right, here we go. One more before dinner. I'm gonna get this going. Thank you, Carnival. Okay. Okay, dinner's coming out. It's coming out, man. And we're gonna eat some good food tonight. Okay, and this is just a sample of Memorial Day weekend for the Grippo family. Right? And Kari's birthday. Kari's birthday is coming up this week, and this is all part of it. All right? So stay tuned and watch all of my stuff, okay? Happy Memorial Day. The food's coming out in a second.
Okay.
I gotta move my martini out of the way because I need my cutting board here. All right, so I'm gonna move my martini over to the side. Okay? And then I'm coming over here and I got everything in the oven. So I need a towel and I'm gonna take my crab cakes out. I keep calling them crab cakes because I made them in the crab cake fashion, but I'm gonna take my stuffing cakes out of the top, and I have my little spatula. I'm letting the pork still cook a little bit, but I'm gonna plate all of this stuff. Okay, let's see if we got this.
Just do yours, so I can choose mine after.
Okay, so I'm gonna plate one of them. I gotta make the glaze, so I'm gonna put these porks out, and then I'm gonna make the glaze in the pan, okay? And that's gonna take a minute. But remember, when you got a pan in the oven, make sure you got a towel, because I can't tell you how many times I've burned myself. Okay. Nice and crisp on the outside and tender on the inside, okay? Okay, let me give Kari this one. This is going to be your plate, Kari. That's a better cake for you.
Okay.
Okay, switch plates. Give that other one to Grandma. Okay. Just give yours to Grandma.
This is Grandma's. That's my mom.
Okay, so now I got that going, right? And what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to lift them up and I'm going to lay it on the chutney, like so, okay? And then I'm going to take two red peppers and a yellow pepper and I'm going to put them on there. And Kari's going to be my garnish girl and she's going to do that with all of these. And she's gonna look at this one as an example, and she's gonna make them for me. Right, Kari?
Sure.
Okay. Now I'm gonna pull the pork out of the oven. Whoa, look at that shit. Okay. Oh, man. Those are awesome. Those are awesome. Okay. Wow. So now, I'm going to take my plates.
Can I choose mine first?
No.
Right, you know which one's
and then I'm going to take this one, and I'm going to put it here. Like so. Okay? I'm going to plate the other ones, and then I'm going to come back and make the glaze. All right, I got them all on a plate. I have them all on the plate right now. Okay? And I'm bringing the juice that's left over up to a simmer. It's starting to come up right now because this is hot. This shit is hot right here. Okay? I got my fireball.
Uh-oh.
But I got another one for later. Okay? But I got my fireball here. Okay? And we're gonna get that going. And I'm gonna pull out a little bit of brown sugar. Grab a spoon here. I'm gonna pull out a little bit of brown sugar. And I'm gonna put one, 2 tablespoons in. Mr. Lova Lova. Now Mr. Lova Lova. Girl. Mr. Lova Lova. It's hot stuff. I'm Mr. Sure Lover Lover. She call me Mr. Bombastic. Tell me fantastic. Touch me on me back, she says I'm Mr. Roll. And I'm gonna hit it with some fireball. Mantic, call me fantastic. Touch me on me back, she says I'm Mr. Roll.
Okay, about 2 ounces, boy.
Smooth.
just like a silk. Sap and cuddly hug me up like a
quilt. I'm a lyrical lover.
Now take me thin up okay. In with my sexual physique.
That's gonna probably go take about a minute and a half.
Yeah. Well, when you can, you can. And just like a turtle crawling out of my shell. Can you talk to me, somebody put me under a spell. With your couscous perfume, I love your sweet smell. You're the young, girl who can ring my bell. And I can take rejects. And so you tell me go to hell and bombastic. Tell it fantastic. Put me on my box. Of the sweet cold breeze. You don't feel like drive, well baby hand me okay. The keys. And I will take you to a place and set your mind at ease. Don't you take to my foot bottom, baby please. Lord, don't you play with my nose cause I'm a hatch to sneeze. Well are you are the bun and me are the cheese. And if I'm me at the rest of you, me love you the peas. I'm bombastic, really fantastic. Put me on the box, she says I'm Mr. O. Monday, really fantastic. Put me on the box, she says I'm Mr. Boom Boom Boom.
With a pineapple mango training.
With a
fireball blaze.
Give me your loving, girl, your loving real good. I want your loving, y'all be it like you should. Give me your loving, girl, your loving real good. I want your loving, y'all you remember the wood you like to kiss and caress. Rub down every strand of your bandages. I'm bombastic, rated as the best. The best you should get, nothing more, nothing less. Give me your digits, chat on your address. I bet you confess, when you put me to the test that I'm bombastic. Tell me fantastic, don't friend on me box, she says I'm Mr. Romantic. Tell me fantastic, don't friend on me box, she says I'm Mr. Boom. Says I'm Mr. Romantic. Tell me fantastic. Touch me on me box. She says I'm Mr. Bombastic. Why? Girl, your admiration it a lift me from the start. With some physical attraction, girl, you know to feel the spark. I want a few words. Now go tell you no sweetheart. Now go la ba la ba la ba la na chop your fart. I'll get straight to the point, like a horror dart. I'ma lay down in a jacuzzi and get some bubble bath. Only song you will hear is the beating of my heart, and we will and have some sweet pillow talk and bombastic. Fantastic.
Show these girls that I own them. Some call me Nicky and some call me Roman. Caesar, please, I'm in a visa. Just happy to not eat my own sneaker. Sexy, sexy, that's all I do. If you need a bad bitch, let me call up yo. I'm so and I'm living many services out. I see some good girls, I'ma turn them out. Okay, bottle, sip, bottle, guzzle. I'm a bad bitch, no muzzle. Hey, bottle, sip, bottle, guzzle. I'm a bad bitch, no muzzle.
Music makes me.